points for this evening. Number one, if you feel the need to talk, try not to do it so that the rest of us can hear you. We don't want to hear about how your kid is always on the iPad and other nonsense like that. Number two, try not to eat all the naan bread. Do you not find that really annoying? Table 9, I'm watching you. Or politicians. It's election time. They might even listen.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and thank you for that very warm welcome.
All right, the award one is for the public service. So we have the public service award, which this year sees a shortlist of all women. All our four finalists have excelled in their respective fields and have made a lasting impression in their communities. The Education Achievement Award is sponsored by UCLAN, which is a university that's been an ardent supporter of this event for many, many years, and we're very grateful to them for that. This year, the award goes to a 13-year-old boy whose commitment to football coaching is quite simply amazing.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Hope you're having a great evening. Obviously, I'm not Fritz. I'm representing Fritz from Supreme Group Events. I've worked in the chat for many years. It's quite a great setup for you guys tonight. So I hope you're enjoying that. So without further ado,
I'd also like to thank my parents, because without them, we wouldn't be where we are today, because it was their dream. We've carried it forward, and we've achieved what we need to. I'm sure we'll be carrying on, moving forward, we'll be carrying on their dream, and make a great success. Have a great evening, guys. Thank you, and jazakallah.
Investment in young people is very important to our business, and we run a number of early careers programmes across the globe. Tonight we are joined by some participants of our Northwest Apprentice and Graduate programmes. We acknowledge the value and importance of developing and empowering young people who will be the future of our businesses and our communities. It is imperative that we recognise how young people add a richness to the diversity of our culture, bringing the breadth of both thought and experience. I'd sincerely like to congratulate all of the nominees. I truly believe that the work you're doing is truly inspirational and is making a difference to the community. And the winner of the 27th Fusion Youth Leadership Award goes to, I'm going to do the whole envelope for the Blackburn United goes to.
Sure.
Would you please welcome Rahida Banu? Ladies and gentlemen, assalamu alaikum, sasrika, namaste, kemcho, and very good evening to you. Hope you're all having a nice evening tonight. Is that a yes? Well, I have to say it's fantastic to see so many people here from such diverse communities, and not just from Lancashire, but I've bumped into people this evening from Oldham and also from Manchester, and in fact from right across the Northwest region. I've been a judge for the Fusion Awards, I think now, for about 10 years. And each year, the quality of the entries has got better and better. And ladies and gentlemen, this year, the nominations were absolutely outstanding. The calibre of the entries was excellent. Now, some of the entries were very difficult to judge because the nominations were mentioned of such excellent standard. And I must actually commend Shuaib for putting on these awards to recognise community champions and heroes, young people and leaders, because this is the only award ceremony of its kind on this scale in the Northwest region. So ladies and gentlemen, will you please join me, joining your hands, to commend Shuaib for putting on this fantastic award. The winner of the Achievement in Sport Award 2017 is Pooja Badwa.
Thank you. Well, so we've been sponsoring sport for the past 3 years now, and each time we look at the competition and think, how are you going to pick a winner? But somehow they do. So, like to
play.
Right, so the manager final star, Mohammed Patel, Morgan Woody, which is five stars.
Gentlemen, I'm absolutely delighted to present this award.
He's originally from Mombasa in Kenya. He came to this country on the 1st of April 1973, and since then he has officiated hundreds of religious ceremonies across temples in the Northwest for decades. Now, he was a college student during the Second World War, and he has got some abiding memories, one in particular from 1942. This is perhaps referring to the difficulties you were talking about, Kate, but he was actually beaten up and arrested by the British Army after he joined demonstrations to support Mahatma Gandhi. So he is obviously a determined young man. He's got strong values. He certainly demonstrated them then, and he has them today. So, ladies and gentlemen, let's find out just a little bit more about him. Madhusudan Daveji.
Congratulations to all our nominees and our winners tonight.